Hi everyone, Sohan Bala once again, and I'm here with the second part of the story, Three Questions. In the first part of the story, you studied that there was a king who had three questions in his mind, and he thought that if he gets right answer to the three questions, he would never fail. I hope you remember the three questions. The first question was, what is the right time to do something? The second question was, who are the most important people he should listen to? And the third question was, what is the most important thing for him to do? In order to get answers to these three questions, he sent his messengers throughout his kingdom. He also promised a large sum of money to the people who answered his question. So many wise men came from far and wide, and they tried to answer his questions. In the answer to his first question, some of them said that the king should follow a certain timetable. Others said he should do whatever seems necessary at the moment, and some others said that he should go to magicians or other wise men. Now, in the answer to his second question, some suggested he should listen to counselors, others suggested he should listen to priests, and some others suggested he should listen to doctors or to soldiers. In the answer to his third question, some said science was most important, others said fighting was most important for the king, and some others said religious worship was most important. So the king was confused. He didn't know what was the best answer. So he had heard of a hermit who was in a jungle. He had his hut in the jungle, so the king went to the jungle in plain clothes. He tried to go there in disguise, not as a king, but as an ordinary man. He went on his horse, and when he reached the jungle, he left his horse and the bodyguards behind, and he went all alone, walking towards the hermit. He saw the hermit. The hermit was digging the ground. He was preparing beds for flowers. So the king looked at him, went near him, and asked him his three questions. The hermit did not answer. He kept digging the ground. So the king took his spade and started digging the ground. He kept digging, and the hermit was around but did not speak anything. He did not answer his questions. When the sun was setting, the king thought of returning. He kept the spade and started to move. Just then the hermit said that there was someone coming towards them. And that is the end of the first part. Now we'll go to second part of the story, and this is like this. The king saw a bearded man running towards them. His hands were pressed against his stomach, from which blood was oozing. As he reached the king, he fainted and fell to the ground. He had a large wound in his stomach. The king washed the wound and compressed it with his handkerchief. At last the bleeding stopped. The man felt better and asked for water to drink. The king gave him fresh water. The sun had set by then. The king and the hermit carried the wounded man into the hut and laid him on the bed. The tired king also fell asleep. When he woke up, the bearded man asked the king to forgive him. Now, the king didn't know why this man was asking for forgiveness, because he didn't even know this man. The king did not understand why he was asking for forgiveness. When asked, the man explained that in fact he was the king's enemy, because the king had once put his brother to death and seized his property. He had vowed to kill the king, so he had followed the king to take revenge on him. The man had hidden himself in a bush on the way to the jungle, but came out of his hiding place when the king did not return for long. He got wounded by the king's bodyguards and would have died if the king had not dressed his wound. He felt grateful to the king who had saved his life. He promised to serve the king as a faithful servant. Actually, the king was unaware that he had some enemy, and this man had become his enemy from the time the king had killed his brother. So the man had decided, he had taken a vow to kill him, and he had come following him to the jungle. He hid himself in the jungle, waited for the king to return. When the king did not return, the man came out, but he was caught by the king's bodyguards and they tried to kill him. But he ran away from there, ran towards the king, and then the king dressed him twice, made him comfortable, gave him water to drink, put him to bed, and then said, then asked him for, that this man asked for forgiveness. The king didn't understand. The king asked why he was asking for forgiveness. So the man explained at that time the whole story. Now the king promised to return his property and help him. The king was happy that he had made peace with his enemy. He forgave the man and promised to give back his property. He also promised to send his doctor and his servant to look after him. The king then went up to the hermit. He again asked for the answers to his three questions. The hermit explained that by digging the beds for him, the king had escaped attack from the bearded man. So the most important time was when he was digging the beds, because by digging the beds he escaped death. The hermit himself was the most important person. Why? Because he was helping the hermit. So to do him good was the king's most important business. And the hermit further told the king that the most important person for him was the person with him at that particular moment. And the most important business was to help that person. So what was he doing at that time? He was helping the wounded man. And the most important time was now. That is the present moment. So the hermit had answered the king's question in a very subtle manner. He said the most important time is now. The most important person is the person with whom he is at that moment, and the most important thing to do is to help that person. Now let's come to the questions from this text. How did the king and the hermit help the wounded man? I hope you must have understood. How did they help the wounded man? The king and the hermit removed his clothes. The king washed the wound and covered it with his handkerchief. When the bleeding did not stop, he dressed the wound a second time. Then the king and the hermit carried the man to a bed in the hut. This is how they helped the wounded man. Now we come to the next question. Who was the bearded man? I hope you know who this man was. The bearded man was the king's enemy. The king had killed the man's brother and confiscated all his property. He had taken a vow to avenge himself. The king was not aware of it, but the man had decided to kill the king. Now let's go to the next question. Why did the bearded man ask for the king's forgiveness? See, the king was not even aware who this man was, and when he asked for forgiveness, the king was taken aback. So why did the bearded man ask for the king's forgiveness? Here is the answer. He asked for the king's forgiveness because the king had saved his life, whereas he felt guilty at heart because he had come to kill the king. Now, next question comes. The king forgave the bearded man. What did he do to show his forgiveness? The answer is, the king promised to send his servant and the doctor to look after him. He also promised to return his property seized by him. Now, let's go ahead. What were the hermit's answers to the three questions? Write each answer separately. Which answer do you like the most and why? This is the most important question of this lesson. What were the hermit's answer to three questions? So, we will go through these answers separately. The hermit answered the king's questions in the following way. He said that now, the present time was the best time. Had he gone back, he would have been killed by his enemy. But he used his present time in helping the hermit. So, present time is the best time, or now is the best time to do anything. Second answer, the bearded man whom he helped was the best man at the moment. See, the king had asked that who is the best person for him to listen to or to pay attention to or to take advice from. So, the hermit said the bearded man whom he helped was the best man at the moment. In fact, the hermit was also the best man at the moment when he reached. And later, when the bearded man approached him, bearded man was the best man at the moment. And the answer to the third question was, to do good to the hermit and the bearded man was the most important thing for the king. So, most important task was to help the hermit and the bearded man. And that is the answer for the third question. Now, which one do you like the best? I like the answer to the first question the most, because present time is the best time. We must make use of present the most and live it fully. Now, let's come to the assignment. I've given you two assignments. First, imagine you are the king. Narrate the incident of your meeting the hermit in about 100 words. And second one is, imagine you are the hermit. Write briefly the incident of your meeting the king. Now, both these are two aspects of the same coin. One is the king, other one is the hermit. They meet each other. So, both of them have different feelings. So, write the feelings of both separately. And that will be your assignment to be answered in your notebooks. And you can show it to us when you meet us. That is the end of the second part. And now, I request you to complete all the exercises which are given in your NCERT book. Please take help of your dictionary and try to complete all the exercises. Don't leave any question unattended. Thank you so much, and bye till we meet again.